literally happens to me every time I record a video. Like, I try to fucking record a video and someone always wants to fucking text me. Okay, you guys, so I'm gonna be kind of in the same, you know, scenery, because I like this white background. Like, I feel like it makes me so bright looking. It makes me like open up. It looks like makes my features look really pretty. So I kind of like this white background. So even though it's kind of boring as hell, I kind of like it. So I'm probably gonna stay here for just a little bit, you know, just a couple weeks or whatnot. So yeah, let me know if that's okay with you guys, if you like my little white background and shit, because I really do like this background, I really do. But let's get right into the video. So today I'm going to talk about my story time. Now this is going to be the fourth day of story time. Now you guys highly requested this video. Don't know why y'all wanted to see this video so bad, but I'm gonna give it to y'all. So first things first, you guys kept talking to me and you wanted to know my first sexual experience. Now, I am a lesbian, but I have dated guys previously when I was younger, and I did have one sexual encounter with one guy when I was younger, and the shit was a fucking fluke. It was horrible as fuck, and that's not why I'm lesbian at all, because it is what it is. I was still, I believe, in high school, so yeah, don't judge me, nigga. Don't, you know, it is what it is. I'm not like one of those people out here that got hella babies and then they want to turn lesbian. No, I'm being honest with you guys. I'm being honest. But first things first, I want to say, because I know I have a lot of young viewers on here, do not just go out here and run and lose your virginity just because I'm talking about it. Because, honey, if you got the shit, save it, keep it, lock it up, you know, save it for that guy or that girl that you want to talk to. Yeah, so definitely save that. Don't be just throwing it out here to the world. Just keep it on lock and key. I don't really believe in waiting to have sex until marriage. I'm not gonna lie. I'm not one of those people that believe that. These are just my beliefs, though. I'm not trying to change nobody or convert anybody. I'm just saying, I don't really believe in that. I feel like you can have sex, but you just make sure you're having sex with the right person. This is somebody you really like. You really, truly believe and know that they are down for you. It is what it is. I'm not with the common beliefs. I'm a millennial baby. What the fuck, yo? I never can talk. So I used to talk to this guy. I still know this guy. I still see this guy on the regular when I go home to my mother's in them house. Like, well, not my mother's house, but like somewhere near my mother's house. He lived in this town over, you know? Okay, so I was talking to this guy for months. And it's the thing. I would talk to somebody for months and never do nothing with them. Like, that's what I was known for. But everybody just thought it was cute because they thought I was like a catch. But whatever. So I was talking to this guy. I know damn near like a year. Almost over a year, just talking to the guy, texting him. We was really cool friends. And the fucking truck, this gotta be the same truck. I don't know, one day I just was like, I was talking to my friend and she was not really that good of a friend. She was just like, girl, go in there, master that D, go ahead and turn it up. You know you got this. You are a winner. You're gonna fucking do this. Like, you're gonna come out like a champ. That's what she was telling me, because she was older than me. But see, that's my problem. When I was younger, I was hanging with people that was older than me. So it was like, I was hanging with people older than me and they were already experiencing stuff. So they were just like, yeah, you can do it. Go ahead, be a champ. Yeah. And I shouldn't have listened to them because they were too old to be hanging with me and they were fucking telling me the wrong goddamn thing to do. You hear me? If you don't have a friend, I'm your friend. I'm telling you, just hold on to it. Wait a minute. This is what happened. So she was like pumping me up to do it. And I'm like, okay, well, I've known him over a year. I can probably go ahead and do it. Blah, 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 blah. And the thing about it is he had a friend. Me and his friend is still like this close. But his friend was fucking downstairs. When I walked in the house, his friend was downstairs. He did not know this was going to happen. Nobody knew this was going to happen. I had it in my mind. And my friend that I just left, she had it in her fucking mind. But nobody else had it in their mind. So I believe, like I said, she was older. So she dropped me the fuck off at his house. So when I get in there, his homeboy was sitting downstairs. Him and his homeboy. And I was sitting down there with him. So I was like, oh, let's go upstairs. Being a little bougie ass dumb bitch. And he was like, okay, cool. So we go up there. And I'm thinking to myself, I know I like girls. But maybe I can make myself stop liking girls if I have sex with this guy. That was what I was thinking. Because that goes to show you how dumb and young I was. Immediately, he pushed himself up on me. Like, he must already knew what it was. He already started pushing himself up on me. And I was like, oh my God, it's happening. It's happening. That's what I kept thinking to myself. It started happening. I was just like, okay. Well, nothing really happened. He was just like pulling my clothes and like kissing me and stuff like that. So I'm like, whatever. So this is the like kind of funny, crazy part. So he started like finally my pants is down. I believe I feel so fucking weird telling this story. I just noticed that, yeah. But anyway, so finally my pants is down, whatever. And he tries to give me like oral. It was fucking shitty. So I'm like, get the fuck off me. I was like, like leave me alone, like get off me. You know, I still have my fucking shirt on. And he was just pumped, like he's already blah, blah, blah. So I'm just sitting there like, okay, what's next? My God, literally, it was crazy because he was so not paying attention to what the fuck I was doing. I had my phone in my hand. I was still like texting somebody. That's how much I was not into it. I was still texting somebody. That's kind of fucked up. What if he watched this video? If he watched this video, he deserved to watch it because like you need to know that was fucking wrong. And see, I was a little liar back then, so I would make it like I wasn't a virgin or nothing like that. So I'm still texting, and he was like trying to put it in. Like mind you, this nigga's weenie was like pencil size, like pencil, like teeny tiny. So I'm like not really paying attention, but I did see him slip a condom on, so I ain't that stupid. So he slipped it on, and he's still trying to put it in, and he's like pumping, which is weird. He's pumping, but guess what? He's nowhere in my coochie. He's nowhere in my, like, he's nowhere near my coochie. He's literally doing this between my butt cheeks. He was nowhere in my coochie, and I knew he wasn't in my coochie. Maybe he... He wasn't in it. Like, he was not in my vagina. He was between my butt cheeks. These are my two butt cheeks. One cheek, left. This is like left cheek, right cheek, you know? Is this my left? No. Right cheek, left cheek. Yeah. This, to me, this is right cheek, left cheek. Two butt cheeks. Okay. Let me see if I can work this out. Now, this is his weenie. Literally. Between my butt cheek. No. Sorry. Lie. Okay, because that would have stuck it inside my butt cheeks. He didn't stick it in my butt cheeks. He was literally, this my two butt cheeks laying on the bed. And this him. Pew, pew, pew. Literally, it's two butt cheeks and he's between there like this. So he's literally like just grazing my butt. He's not even like in my butthole or nothing like that. I'm thinking to myself while I'm texting, I do not think this is right, because shouldn't this shit hurt? And shouldn't this, like, you're so unexperienced. Like, I was more experienced than I hadn't even had sex. I'm like, this one is short, like, you're not even in there. He was like, what? And then he looked at me, he's like, oh, shit. That's what he fucking said. Oh, shit. So I'm like, yeah. And he begins to, you know, maneuver his way down there and, like, just go ahead and, like, tries to jam it in. I'm like, this is not what I fucking signed up for. And literally I was like, okay, I'm up, like I'm getting up now. And he was like, what's wrong, what's going on? I was like, yeah, this is not it. I say I lost my virginity because of course when he fucking jammed me, I was, you know, bleeding a little teeny bit, but it wasn't like my cherry had been fucking popped or nothing like that, because it was like a wrap. Like that was the fucking end of it. Like, that's why I said I lost my virginity in a way, because that was my first time with like a penis down that area, and then like it kind of went in a little bit, but it didn't go in. So that's why I said I lost my virginity. But after that, I was strictly females. Like, I was like, I know females are for me. That's what I need. This is in my life. Like after that, fuck that. I was on to females like no other. Like that was my next move, and I loved it. Like every time I had a sexual encounter with a female, I was like, oh my God. I'm even talking about with any type of sexual encounter with a female. I was just like, oh my God, yes, this is it. This is what I've been fucking waiting on. Like, that's what I felt like. But with him, like, after that, I did not talk to him. Fucking, and I went to my friend. I was like, he did not know what he was fucking doing. Like, you couldn't eat my coochie right. You couldn't stick nothing in me. Like, you couldn't do nothing right. Like, there was nothing right. To be honest, that experience had really nothing to do with me turning into a lesbian. It didn't. Because I was already a lesbian before then. I was just trying to put those feelings off. But after him, his young ass, well, he wasn't even that young, he was older than me, and he had had way more sexual partners. Well, that was my first, but he had sexual partners, so you would think that he knew what he was fucking doing. But Bitch, he didn't. To all my young girls, see what type of tragic situation I was in? See? But, my God, horrible. But if he's watching this, nigga, you need to step your weenie game up. Because one, it was small. You couldn't eat coochie. And it just was not right. Like, it wasn't right. But you guys, that was a story time on when I lost my virginity. And I hope you guys enjoy this story. Learn from this story. For my young viewers, learn from the story. Because everybody isn't deserving of it. I don't even, well, I kind of say that's losing my virginity to a guy. But I don't know. Like, I feel like I really lost my virginity to a female. You know what I mean? Like, I could tell. But, yeah, you guys, stay tuned to my next story time, which is tomorrow. Tomorrow is my next story time, so definitely stay tuned to that, because that will be tomorrow will be the end of story time week. If you guys comment below, like, let me know if you want me to do another story time week. I will definitely put that together for you guys. I just need to know that y'all want them. And then after that, I can, you know, just work that magic in and shit like that. So yeah. But I hope you guys enjoy. Don't forget to comment, like, and subscribe. And I'll see you guys. Mwah. See ya.